keep it to yourself. And what I'm referring to is your recovery journey. You don't have to tell anybody that you're in recovery. Your boss, your friends, your family, your girlfriend even your spouse, if you can get away with not telling her or telling him that you're in recovery. You don't have to tell anybody. Anonymity is really, really important. It really is. The whole world nowadays is talking about mental health. You gotta help the people with mental health, depression, anxiety, there's fentanyl addiction, it's killing people. But there is still a stigma. They're still labeling us as weak people, or it's just a habit. You know, I'm at work and these people are innocently talking about street people as being, like I just said, weak-willed, it's their choice, they're just lazy. You know, they should get a job and pay their rent. It's like a choice for them to live on the street. There probably is a few of them living on the street as a choice. Alcoholism is not a choice, and we are not weak-willed people, and we're not lazy people. But there's a lot of labels and a lot of opinions against people in addiction. If I went to an interview one time, and I told them I was an alcoholic, and I'm recovering from alcoholism, you know, one day I miss work, and they kind of give me a pot shot. Oh, we thought you were out drinking the other day. Well, that was a long time ago, but it did happen. People will think of that if something goes wrong in our lives. And anonymity is very important not to tell people. I told people, all kinds of people, as an alcoholic. I got ribbed a lot. I got put down a bit because they thought, oh yeah, you're not an alcoholic, you know, whatever. You just need to quit drinking and get your life in order. There's a lot of things going around about it, but also, it made me feel a little different sometimes too. I'd walk up to people, say, I'm a recovering alcoholic, you know. All my life in my active alcoholism, I always felt different. I always felt different. And sometimes by telling my employer that I was a recovering alcoholic, I would believe that it was giving me a bit of a leg up in that interview. Like I was a great guy getting my life in order, but they didn't really care. They didn't really give a shit. I'm a city bus driver. I don't go around telling my boss I'm an alcoholic. I'm a bus driver. Like, no way I'm telling them I'm not an active alcoholic, but a recovering alcoholic. I don't tell a lot of people. And the main reason I don't tell them is to protect myself also from it. Because like I say, there's a lot of labels and there's a lot of prejudgment or prejudice against people. And I don't like saying it, but it's the truth. So I'm very selective who I tell that I'm in recovery. I've been in recovery for a long, long time. I've been in recovery, it's going up to 29 years, and I still don't tell the world that I am in recovery. I don't want to feel different, and I don't want them to look at me as being different. Because like I said, I know I'm repeating myself, there's a lot of stigma attached to it. There really, really is. Just think of it, when somebody walks up to you and tells them that they're an alcoholic, you kind of think a little different too, right? Because I know guys who are active alcoholics and they're at work or friends of mine and they screw up and we gossip. I don't like to say it, but there's gossip about him. Oh, look at that guy. He screwed up because he's an alcoholic. He drinks a lot because he's an alcoholic. Look at Terry G. He didn't show up. He doesn't want to come to the party because he's an alcoholic. It happens. People are human and they will judge us and they'll put labels on us and they think that we are less than. And you may not get that promotion. You may not get that girlfriend or boyfriend you want because you are in recovery. When I tell people that I'm an alcoholic and I'm in a program of recovery is when the need be, when there's a purpose to do it. Somebody's struggling and maybe I can reach out and help them. I blow my cover, I blow my anonymity. Or somebody, you know, those kind of things. When there's a positive reason for sharing my recovery story to them or relating to them or helping somebody up from the hellhole of addiction. But telling the regular Joe Blow that I'm in recovery, I don't do that. I've been embarrassed number of times because I don't drink. I believe that I've missed out on jobs because I've told employers in interviews that I'm a recovering alcoholic. I believe about 6 months ago, I applied for a volunteer position at work. I told them I was in a 12-step program. I believe I didn't get that volunteer position because I told them I was a recovering alcoholic. And those things that I just told you may not be true. I may be just imagining it, but I don't think so. I could tell by their body language and the way they looked at me after that there was a little bit of change in the interviews, what was going on. That's how I could tell. But I'm very proud of being in recovery. I'm very proud of my sobriety, but anonymity protects us from the outside world. And myself, I always felt different when I was an active alcoholic. And not telling people that I'm addictive, I'm a recovering alcoholic, I don't have to feel different either. I can just feel like a regular person on the street, but I don't drink. That's all. I just don't drink. I don't go to parties and tell people that I'm an alcoholic. I just don't. I keep it to myself because that's what I do. That's what I do, okay? So just remember that. You don't have to tell anybody you're in recovery. You can keep it to yourself, and for years or days or whatever, you can keep it to yourself. Believe it or not, I know I have kept it to myself for many, many years. A lot of people know I don't drink, but a lot of people know also don't know that I'm in a 12-step program. They really don't. So just remember that, okay? Just remember, keep it to yourself, okay? Ciao for now. I'm Terry G. This is an alcohol-free life channel where we learn to live sober one day at a time. If you could take a second, can you please subscribe to my channel? I'd really appreciate it. But can you all just leave a comment or hit that like button, okay? Thanks again. I'll see you next week. Ciao for now. Stay safe, stay sober, and remember, we're all in it together. We are all in this together. Let's get up sober and have a great life. Ciao for now. Bye-bye.